Okay, so welcome to my I don't know how many episode. Okay, so today we're gonna talk about a very important topic. Okay, what happened is we're gonna talk about COVID-19 and we're gonna talk about how it affects the property market. Okay, it's not going to be a very focused topic, as in meaning that I'm not going to focus on a certain sector or a certain thing to talk about. I'm just going to give you my personal opinion and how I see it and what is really happening in the market. Okay, so okay, let's go. Okay, so basically we just have to understand one thing. I will split my whole video right into three parts. So first of all, we talk about COVID-19. Okay, how is it going to affect the economy as well as how is it going to affect the property? Then we're going to go to the end to talk about how is it going to affect the property, because from here we're going to snowball to here. Okay, so first of all, we have to understand one thing. Today, COVID-19 has hit us. Okay, we have not go for a lockdown yet. Other countries have go for a lockdown, and we have already seen some industry and some sectors losing money. Okay, so today, if you are in aviation, you are in tourism, you are in events, I think you will suffer the most. But today, if you are like supermarket, food, delivery, I think you won't suffer so much. Or maybe there's other industry that I'm not too sure that will suffer a lot, and some industry that don't, you know. I don't have a full knowledge of that. But definitely there is people that will see it as an opportunity, and there's people that see it as a crisis. So firstly, we have to understand this first, okay? Whoever, what I mean by whoever is in which country that is going to perform well and is going to stand up from this crisis is going to recover the fastest. Okay, first we have to understand this. So today, if you think that the Singapore government is doing well with all this managing of all these crises, you think that the Singapore government is performing well to prevent this problem from becoming bigger and preventing Singapore from going to a lockdown. Anyway, this video is filmed when our entertainment centers are closed and all these things, 1 meter social distancing, but we haven't locked down yet. So when I post this video, I don't know whether we're going to a lockdown or not, but I hope that we are not, because a lockdown is serious, okay? Serious. So basically, we have to understand this first, okay? Which country is going to recover faster after this pandemic? And I'm pretty sure in what we see in our charts and what is our government doing, we have come up with test kits, you know. We are already very prepared, and we are actually one of the top countries in terms of preventing this pandemic to affect our country. So I think this is a very good thing, because it puts us on the map again, and it puts us on the map for a good reason, and it shows that we are a very safe country and we are ready for such problems. So with this happening, right, I'm pretty sure we will actually recover the fastest, and we will strive to be one of the biggest economy. To me, you see, there's going to be a re-ranking, meaning that let's say today you are number 4, then he's number 2, number 3, number 1. Then because of this crisis, right, you will see that whoever that managed the crisis well, managed the virus well, will actually be number 2 next time. So this is like an economy reset, you know, if you see it correctly. Definitely there's people that will get affected, but there were also people that actually benefit from it. Those people that save enough money will go and buy shares, will put their money in the right place, because they know that when it recovers, they're going to earn a lot of money. So the second thing we're going to talk about is the property market. So the only problem that is going to affect the property market now is unemployment. Okay, many people will think that, hey, this virus will affect the market because of investment. When this word investment is being used, I think it's very subjective and it's not being used in the correct way. Like our minister says that we use the word lockdown too loosely. Okay, so I think when it comes to property investment, it's really used too loosely also. So what am I trying to say is, because you see, 2018, 2019, people have been saying, economic crisis, Singapore is going to go in economic crisis. We have been talking about this economic crisis thing for the whole of 2019. And since like 2013 or even before that, the government has came up with so many floodgates, came up with so many rules and regulations for TDSR, for MSR, for ABSD, to prevent people from over-leveraging themselves, to prevent people from overloading themselves. So today, actually, I don't know, we may be lucky. Lucky in a way that the government has been controlling the market, the property market very well. And if you always hear the word that the bubble may burst and all these things, I think we have never had a bubble, because our bubble can never be burst, because our bubble is never too big. So I think today is a very good example. If you go and look at property markets in other countries, I'm pretty sure you see a burst. I'm pretty sure something has exploded somewhere. Okay, so today, because of the government being controlling this factor, I don't see a lot of pure property investor in the market. Okay, and most of the people buying today are really homeowners, meaning that you buy to stay. Okay, so we're gonna go into a very important part now. The only thing that is going to affect these people and affect the property market, okay, or affect the resale property market and to make people to have a panic selling, is when unemployment hits the market. So if today you are buying within your means and you have saved well, you have not overspent and you keep your job well, you continue to work hard, and in this crisis your company do well, even a bit of adjustment in terms of income, you'll still be able to pay the installment for your house. Okay, if you are able to pay the installment for your house and you still need a house to stay, no matter whether is it a pandemic or a virus, whether is it COVID-18, 19 and 20, you still need a place to stay. If you need a place to stay, you will not sell your place. So if you will not sell your place, I don't see how is the resale market going to get affected in a big way. Okay, but definitely There is people. We have to accept the fact that definitely there is people that is going to go into unemployment problems and they overload themselves. But to be frank, because of all the floodgates and all the rule and measures that is being put in place from 2013 to 2018, right? I don't think we will have so many people that will do a panic selling. If there is not many people that will do a panic selling, you won't see a very steep fall in terms of prices. But you will definitely see a slight fall in terms of prices in the resale market. Okay, in the resale market. Then, actually most of the time I got the question was not about the resale market. It's about the new launch market. People will tell me, hey Aaron, so what do you think about the new launch market? You know, is developer ready to drop price and all these things? Okay, so let's talk about this, because I feel that this video, I'm going to elaborate everything and it's going to be quite long, because I really want to be there to share everything correctly to everyone now. So for the new launch market, right, we understand that the supply came in 2019. To today, right, some of the 2019 projects is about a year, or some maybe less than a year. Firstly, we have to understand in 2019, we are already, these projects, this developer has already been selling their project at a very low profit margin manner, because of the word economic crisis is coming. So you realize that if you look at the land price, the break even, the construction, you know that these people are already, this developer already selling their place at a very low profit margin. And today they have close to another 3 to 4 years to sell their project. If you are the developer, first, I don't think you will increase price. Second, I don't think you will drop price also. Why? Because you have a lot of time to sell and you are really not earning a lot from it. So we have to understand that if today you buy a new launch, right, you don't expect developer to drop price drastically, because the pricing that they already put up and they already priced, if you watch my other videos like cost averaging and everything, you know that they are actually putting it at a very reasonable price and they are doing a cost averaging. Last year was year one, this year was year two. By right, they will slowly increase. But do you think they will increase in this pandemic moment? I don't think so. So today you realize that people that buy in 2020, they benefit from one more thing, which is because of the shares collapsing and everything, our mortgage interest rate is at 1.2 to 1.3. I did a calculation for 1 million loan. 1.2 to 1.3 the difference between 1.2, 1.3 to 1.98, right? The difference is 90,000, around about 90 to 100,000 in terms of interest. That's how much you save. So it makes a very big difference. Okay, we're talking about 30 years lease, full lease. Okay, so the interest makes a very, very big difference. So today, if you buy, you actually benefit from it. And today, those people that buy BUC, there's no lock-in. So they will still do a repricing. They are still able to reprice to a SIBOR as of now. Okay, so if you haven't do it right, you can go and call your bank and do a repricing. I'm pretty sure most of the BUC allows you to do a repricing. I'm not too sure if there's a cost or not, but it's definitely worth it to reprice from 1.98, which is previous the FD rate, to 1.3. Okay, so BUC normally there's no lock-in. Okay, meaning I'm building under construction. If you bought like last year, you bought Treasures, or you bought Jadescape, or you bought Park Astar, etc. So the new launch market is not going to get affected so much. And because they are on normal progressive payment, meaning their installments are at a lower rate because they haven't finished building. So you will realize that their installment is still very, very low. So this is not going to be a big problem for them. Even if there's a pay cut, all these people are still able to pay up. And because there's a 3 years SSD, these people won't say, oh, the price dropped, there's a crisis, then they start selling away. So you will not see sub-sale around also because of the SSD. You will not see developer pulling down price because we are not at our peak. And you know that the amount that developer is earning, and you know in 2019 there's so many supplies. Developers are very sensitive. If you subscribe to my videos and my channel, you know what's happening. So you don't see the developer doing a drastic price adjustment because of the pandemic. And this thing is not going to last us for 2-3 years. So as of today, the developer are still observing. If this thing is really going to last us for 2-3 years, then something big is going to happen. It is going to be very, very terrible. But in our heart, we know that it won't go there. I think the most 1 year, then you start seeing vaccines and everything. Every scientist, doctors, professor in the world is trying to come up with a vaccine now. It's to save people, but also whoever come up with a vaccine now will also earn the most. So, I mean, this is the truth of the world. We cannot avoid it. So, today, you want to understand if this pandemic, this virus, COVID-19, is it going to really hit the industry? My answer is yes. But how much is the question that you got to think about? Whether to buy today also depends on you. If you are in the sector that unemployment will hit you, then you have to be careful. But if you are in the sector that you don't think unemployment will hit you, then you should take advantage of this moment to actually buy the right property. So no matter whether is it a pandemic or is a not a pandemic moment, I still think that it's very, very important to buy the correct property. So we will continue to do our videos, and also because we have moved to a new studio, I actually did this video like 30 minutes ago, but the camera wasn't set properly and there was some focus problem and everything. So I will most likely make it to a podcast or something. So anyway, if you like my video, hit the subscribe button, hit the like button, and thank you for watching. And we will share more in the next episode. We will talk more about how this virus is going to affect the other markets in a very specific manner, like how resale will get affected, how HDB will get affected, how private will get affected. And also within the last few months, I also seen buyers buying their property in a very, very casual way. They're not taking it too seriously. So I'm going to share more tips in the next few weeks to come. So thank you for watching. Hit the subscribe button. Anyway, you already watched until the end, so just hit the subscribe button, right? Okay, thank you very much, and I see you again. Bye bye.